I mean, it hasn't sunk in yet. Really, all I can think about is Coastal Carolina. All I can think about is getting down to Raleigh, getting back to work, watching film, getting into practice. So, it definitely hasn't sunk in, but it's probably a good thing it hasn't. We took today off, so we haven't watched any film or anything. But, they're a dangerous team. They got into the tournament, and we have to treat everybody the same at this point. So, we played in the Corpus Christi Challenge, which is we kind of joke about that. But, it helped. And being able to play again in the ACC tournament and having that experience of consecutive days of playing, it'll bode well for us down the stretch because we know what it's like to have to face a good team every day. I mean, none of us on this team really cared about who got the MVP as long as we won. It's just a testament to the camaraderie and the passion that we have for each other on this team.
So for a guy who didn't get recruited by any other ACC school to win the ACC tournament in your fourth year in your home state, especially sweet.
Yeah, I mean, it was nice. And to beat Duke, I was a huge Duke fan, you guys know that. To beat Duke in Greensboro in front of my family and friends, it means a lot to me. It means the world.
For sure. AG plays as big of a role on this team as anybody does. He comes in the game off the bench. I tell everybody, he could start on any team in the country, including ours. But he comes off the bench and gives us the same energy and the same offense and defensive play that he would give if he started. He's a key reason why we've had the success we've had.
And the senior leadership with Joe and Akil, I know all you guys have kind of developed and matured as the season has gone along, but how beneficial are they going to be this week for you all?
Very beneficial. I think they're the only two, other than Darion, that have actually played in the NCAA tournament. I haven't played in the NCAA tournament yet. They have that experience. They played big roles when they went there 2 years ago. So it's going to be huge for them to step up and really be vocal and just be really vocal leaders for us and take charge and lead us. To go from not getting in to being a number one seed, it's really a blessing, but it's a great opportunity to just keep moving forward and keep competing.
Staff,
I feel like we've developed really good chemistry and camaraderie as a team, and everybody buying into the program and not having agendas has really set the tone.
A little bit sitting there, just watching the selection Sunday and just seeing our name called, it was a special moment. It was a huge moment for the program. But, our celebration was short-lived. Now it's all about focusing and preparing and getting ready for our next game.
Definitely.
I mean, we've experienced, the low of last year of watching and not getting our name called. And then this year, the high of getting the number one seed. And I think because we were able to experience that last year, that makes us that much more grateful and just thankful to, even have the opportunity to play in the tournament and get the number one seed. I think this team, we don't really worry about any of that stuff a whole lot. We'll definitely not overlook anybody that we're playing against because we are number one seed. We know that it's all about improving and trying to get better, one day at a time. We're more focused and concerned with practice tomorrow and preparing the right way and getting ready for Coastal Carolina. It's not just Akil and I. I think, this team across the board has got a lot of very good leaders and mature players. And, I think it's huge, especially coming into postseason play. That's when the leadership and all that stuff is so much more important. Is when you have the games, you lose, you're done. You win, you go on, and that's when it's all. That's when it really matters. Is right then.